Good evening, Toastmasters and guests. Thank you for turning up in traditional clothes today. You've actually done half my job. The theme of the day was decided that we'll be celebrating Independence Day. And if all of you could come in traditional clothing, it'll give us a lot of, it'll make the occasion much better. So can we give ourselves a loud round of applause? So what's so special about traditional clothing? But firstly, I wouldn't like to take the credit for the theme. I would like to give Shudita the credit because she suggested the theme. So thank you, Shudita, for the brilliant theme. So what is so great about wearing traditional clothing? So for me, I think it's that I associate with festivals, you know, with Diwali, Eid, or a special occasion in the family. If you're getting married, you know, if somebody is getting married in the family, that's when you take it out. And that's why I had to take my kurta out today. So that's the thing, you know, tradition, culture, or heritage of India is something that we should celebrate all the time. Not just one day, 2 days, but throughout the year we should be celebrating the culture of India. Why? Because one, of course, it's the oldest living civilization in the world. If anybody has seen that movie 10,000 BC,
yes,
India was existing even before that. That's one fact. Of course, we're the fastest growing economy in the world. There's a slowdown, but that's a global slowdown. We're still going to grow at 6.9%, 7%, which is phenomenal. We have the youngest workforce in the world. So there are many reasons. But what I would like to now talk about though today is specifically the history and culture of India, which I'll be the first one to admit that I've been extremely ignorant of. So let me tell you a story that happened a few years ago and which made me realize how ignorant I actually am or was. So I go to Siri Fort Sports Complex very often to play. Either play football or just run. That day, one day when I was coming out, I saw this really agitated taxi driver talking to a foreigner. Both of them were not being able to understand each other. So the taxi driver stopped me and said, "Sir, aap inki help kar sakte ho? Sir, could you please help them? As I'm not being able to understand them." So the taxi driver was a very old, polite Sardarji by the name of Sant Singh. And this is not the Uber driver, this is your Kali Pili, black and yellow taxis, you know, that we don't see that often right now. So I asked the foreigner. His name was David and he was visiting from the US, Texas. And I asked him, "So what is the matter? What do you think?" So he said, "You know, I want to go to Siri Fort." And he was standing in the middle of Siri Fort Sports Complex. I said, David, this is Siri Fort. And what do you want to play over here?" He said, "No, I haven't come to play. I'm a student of history and culture, and I'm specializing on India. So I've come to visit Delhi and I'm visiting various other places." I said, "I'm sure you come to the wrong place, because Siri Fort has nothing to do with history or culture of India, or for that matter, Delhi." So he said, no, I want to go to Siri Fort." And I said, "This is Siri Fort." So we kept going back and forth for a minute. So suddenly, then he took out, you know, a booklet, which was a guide map to Delhi. And he showed me, look, this picture. I said, "I understand English, you don't need to show this to me." Because I was in Delhi, I've been born and brought up in Delhi, I've lived here for 33 years. And I know South Delhi like the back of my hand. He said, this. I still didn't look. Then I looked at the map. So the map showed me a huge park. And in the middle of a park, there was a little monument. And I was perplexed as to, this is not Siri Fort. And then it struck me. Now, how many of you have been down that road of Khelgaon? If you go towards Shahpur Jat, there's a huge park. And in that park, there are ruins of a monument, which was called Siri Fort. I didn't know that, and I'm sure a lot of you also didn't know that till now. So I Googled, and I wanted to know, and this is my city, Delhi. Like I said, folks, so proud to be a Delhiite. I know everything about my city, but I didn't know this. So I Googled. So Siri Fort is a 1300 century monument built by the great Alauddin Khilji. You've seen the movie Padmavat? Ranveer Singh played that role of Khilji. It was that gentleman who built it. So he was ruling the Khilji dynasty from Siri Fort. And as he expanded his territory, this was his capital. Obviously, the monument has been ruined over the years, but the legend has it, how did Siri Fort get its name? Siri comes from the Hindi word sar, meaning head. Well, this is a little boring, but pardon me, I have to give you the history of, or at least the legend of how it came out. Apparently, the monument is built on the severed heads of 8,000 Mongols who were conquering India at that point of time. The structure was built on that. That was the foundation of the monument. And that is the history of Siri Fort. And that's just one gem out of, I don't know, maybe 1,000, 10,000, 15,000, 20,000 horse cars, India Gate. For me, India Gate is just the roundabout from where I just want to take a left towards CP or Jaipur. I don't really stay and think about the history of the place. Now, why am I talking about all these things? Why? I mean, it's because I wanted to tell, or rather bring this, at least this feeling about how India is so unique. You know, this gentleman, David, flew down 13,500 kilometers across the seven seas to visit India to do this research project. And we were completely ignorant. So I hope now all of us will become a little more, at least we will appreciate the culture and heritage that we are living in. And with that, I would now like to start the meeting. So the Toastmasters session has three sessions. The first one is the prepared speeches, where the speakers will be speaking as per the guidelines given by the Toastmasters International on their topics. The second is the, in a usual Toastmasters session, the second module is the table topics, where even guests are welcome to come and speak on any topic for up to 2 minutes. But today is going to be very special. Why? Why is today going to be special?
Independence Day,
right? So we're going to have a special module by Nimish, who will be joining us, Toastmaster Nimish, will be joining us shortly on humorous speech. And the third session, which of course, you know, after you've spoken and you've heard, you need to know how you've spoken, how you've done. So we will have the evaluation session, where the evaluators will be evaluating and telling us how we've done. So that is the standard format for Toastmasters today. Now, each meeting has to have its core or foundation. Just like India has its core and foundation in the Constitution, the Republic, the government, and all of us. So our meeting has the tag team, the auxiliary role players who are the foundation. So my tag team consists of the timer Rohan. Rohan, would you please come?